Welcome back, Linux enthusiasts. In the ever-evolving landscape of Linux distributions, Fedora has always been at the forefront of innovation. With each new release, Fedora seeks to push the boundaries of what's possible in the world of open-source operating systems. As Fedora Linux 39 is still in development, the Fedora project has already unveiled some exciting plans for its successor, Fedora Linux 40, slated for a May 2024 release. Among the most anticipated changes is the adoption of the KDE Plasma 6 desktop environment on the Wayland Display Protocol, signaling a significant shift away from the traditional X11 session. This bold move provides to bring cutting-edge features and improvements to Fedora users, further solidifying Fedora's position as a forward-thinking Linux distribution. The KDE Plasma desktop environment has been a popular choice among Linux enthusiasts for its stunning visuals, customizability, and user-friendly features. With the development of KDE Plasma 6 underway, the Linux community is eagerly anticipating a major leap in functionality and performance. KDE Plasma 6 is expected to make its debut in early spring 2024, boasting an overhaul that includes the transition to Qt6 and KDE Framework 6, two fundamental pillars of the KDE ecosystem. One of the most significant changes in the KDE Plasma 6 is its comprehensive support for the Wayland Display Protocol. With Fedora Linux 40, KDE Plasma 6 will become the default desktop environment, and the Wayland session will be the primary display protocol. The decision to drop X11 session in Fedora Linux 40 is a bold move that reflects the Linux community commitment to embracing new technologies and retiring outdated ones. While X11 has served as the foundation of the Linux desktop experience for decades, its limitations and vulnerabilities have become increasingly apparent in a rapidly evolving computing landscape. Fedora Linux 40's developers are confident in this transition due to several key factors. Firstly, Wayland is now fully supported by current NVIDIA proprietary graphics driver, a crucial step in ensuring a smooth transition for users who rely on NVIDIA hardware. Secondly, graphics fallback modes have been optimized to work seamlessly with Wayland, reducing the likelihood of compatibility issues. Additionally, Fedora Linux 40 will ship with simple DRM enabled by default, further enhancing the Wayland experience. Red Hat, a key player in the Linux ecosystem and the parent company of Fedora, has also signaled its intent to drop X11 support in a future major release of Red Hat Enterprise Linux. This aligns with the broader industry trend of moving away from X11 in favor of more modern and secure display protocols. While Fedora Linux 40 is set to retire the X11 session, it's important to note that support for X11 application will still be available through the X-Wayland implementation. This means that users can continue to run their favorite X11-based application seamlessly within the KDE Plasma 6 on Wayland environment. The Fedora KDE team is committed to ensuring a smooth transition and compatibility for users. However, they have made it clear that they do not have the resources to maintain the X11 session alongside the rapidly evolving KDE Plasma 6 stack. This decision is rooted in practicality and the intent to focus on the future rather than maintaining legacy components. It's worth noting that the KDE Plasma 6 desktop environment will be exclusive to Fedora Linux 40 and will not be backported to older Fedora Linux releases. Therefore, users who choose to upgrade their Fedora Linux system to version 40 with KDE Plasma 6 will be automatically switched to Plasma Wayland session from the X11 session. Beyond the transition to KDE Plasma 6 and Wayland, Fedora Linux 40 promises several other exciting features and improvements across the board. For the flagship Fedora Workstation Edition, users can expect the inclusion of the Anaconda WebUI installer by default. This modernized installer aims to provide a more user-friendly and intuitive installation experience, making it easier than ever to set up a Fedora system. Fedora Linux 40 will introduce modernized Live Media with support for persistent overlay on USB drives. This enhancement is particularly beneficial for users who want to carry their customized Fedora environment on a portable USB drive, enabling greater flexibility and convenience. Security is a top priority in Fedora Linux, and version 40 will include kernel TLS support for GNU TLS. This improvement enhances the security and performance of network connection, ensuring that users can browse the web and access online service with confidence. To streamline package management, Fedora Linux 40 will introduce DNF RPM copy on write for all editions. This feature enhances the efficiency and reliability of Souter package management, making it easier for users to install, update, and maintain their systems. In conclusion, Fedora Linux 40 is shaping up to be a groundbreaking release that embraces the future of Linux desktop computing. By adopting KDE Plasma 6 and Wayland as the default desktop environment and display protocol, Fedora is not only staying ahead of the curve but also providing users with a more secure, efficient and feature-rich computing experience. The decision to retire X11 Sesshi demonstrates a commitment to progress and willingness to let go of legacy technology in favor of modern alternatives. As Fedora Linux 4 continues to develop, Linux enthusiasts and Fedora users can look forward to a release that pushes the boundaries of what an open source operating system can achieve. If you find this video useful, please like, share, and subscribe.